मेरे बीच नहीं आए, वो मेरे बीच नहीं आए, मैं उनके बीच में क्यों आऊं? उनकी सुबहों और शामों का, उनकी सुबहों और शामों का मैं एक भी लम्हा क्यों पाऊं? मैं पल दो पल का शायर हूं, पल दो पल मेरी कहानी है।
मेरे दिल में आज क्या है तू कहे तो मैं बता दूं। मेरे दिल में आज क्या है तू कहे तो मैं बता दूं।
मैं जिंदगी का साथ निभाता चला गया, हर फिक्र को तुम्हें मैं उड़ाता चला गया।
When Sahir Ludhianvi spotted his estranged lady love Sudha Malhotra at a party, emotion drove him to spontaneously vent his feelings into words.
Chalo ek baar phir se ajnabi ban jaye hum ko, chalo ek baar phir se ajnabi ban jaye hum.
My father was not an admirer of Sahir Sahib, he just adored him. And dad said there will be poets and there will be poets and there will be poets, but there will never be a Sahir Ludhianvi.
This romantic poet, who is considered as one of the greatest lyricists in Bollywood, ironically remained a bachelor all his life. His dalliances with noted poetess Amrita Pritham led her to write love sonnets.
मैं पल दो पल का शायर हूँ, पल दो पल मेरी कहानी है, पल दो पल मेरी हस्ती है, पल दो पल मेरी जवानी है।
Contribution has been his individuality. Sahir, when he came to films, yes, he was also like Majru, he was like the others, he was writing to tune and everything. Later, there was one difficulty about Sahir, that he would write the insist on writing the poetry first. There's also another myth about Sahir, which I would like to explore here. There is this myth, one here, I don't know where it originated, that he charged a rupee more than Lata Mangeshkar. Nothing of the kind. Let us take Kabhi Kabhi as a benchmark. Now that is the time prices went up. Lata Mangeshkar and Mukesh, Kabhi Kabhi Mere Dil Mein. 15,000 to Lata Mangeshkar, 10,000 to Mukesh. Hardly 1,000 rupees, maybe 1,500 because it is B.R. Chopra's scam, Yash Chopra's scam. But I mean, songwriters were never considered, I mean, absolute musts in that sense. They could always be substituted, though Sahir was very difficult to substitute. But the point is that Sahir was a great romanticist, and what he ultimately wrote was something, the ultimate. And even in a bhajan like Allah Tero Naam, Raag Gaur Sarang, Allah Tero Naam, Hum Dono, I mean, he is able to write a bhajan, same as Shailendra. Shailendra could do both. You see, Sahir could do both, but Sahir's name is predominantly as an Urdu poet. And Sahir, I would say, ultimately when you analyze everything, somehow Sahir stands tops.
So besotted was she with Sahir's genius that she would reverentially puff at cigarette butts he had left behind. Yet, for all his many infatuations, Sahir's only constant companion in his life was his mother, Sardar Begum. From Lahore, they shifted to Delhi, and eventually the lure of film industry drew Sahir to Mumbai, where he started out by writing dialogues. But his reputation as a poet had already preceded him, and a collaboration with S.D. Burman resulted in this song.
Most beautiful wonderful memory I have of Sarangal is, he used to go to Khar Market, the Banarsi store, and there they all, there was my father, there was Sarangal, there was Pandit Madhok Saab, and I'm this 10-year-old, 11-year-old child, 12-year-old guy, just standing looking at them, talking, and Sarangal used to drink lassi. So Sarangal used to say, bhai lassi liyao, but shakar mat dalna. And to me that was, नहीं 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 भाई हम हम अंकल हम भी लस्सी पियेंगे मलाई मार के और बहुत शक्कर डालना उसमें हम मीठी लस्सी तो अन्नू के लिए मीठी लस्सी ले आओ
Soon, the success of Bazi would make Sahir the leading lyricist in Hindi films. The popularity of songs of Naujawan, Bazi, Jaal and Dharmputra fine-tuned Sahir's working relationships with Devanand, S.C. Barman, Guru Dutt and B.R. Chopra to form formidable combinations that dominated the film scene for several decades. His mastery over Urdu language, immaculate diction, intensity of feelings and enchanting style of expression made him a lyricist of a different kind.
ये पुरपेच गलियां ये बदनाम बाजार ये गुमनाम राही ये सिक्कों के झनकार ये इस्मत के सौदे ये सौदों पे तकरार जिन्हें नाज है हिंद पर वो कहां है कहां है कहां है कहां है
ये तब तो ये ताज़ों
For many, Sahir's work in Guru Dutt's Pyasa is his finest. Some say the film bears resemblance to his early years as a poet.
ये दौलत के वो के रवाजों के दुनिया ये दुनिया अगर मिल भी जाए तो क्या है ये दुनिया अगर मिल भी जाए तो क्या
Sahir's ability to assess human situations and come up with poetic responses I don't think it's been quite matched.
Ironically, this film also marked the end to Sahir and S.C. Barman partnership. From the time B.R. Chopra started producing and directing films under his banner B.R. Films around 1950, Sahir Lukhanvi remained the preferred songwriter for all his films.
Now Guru Dutt's theme was such that the music had to be underplayed and the poetry had to be prominent in Pyasa, right? Now Pyasa, it has poetry. So Dada Barman, being an intellectual, you see, he saw to it that he gave the Guru Dutt in such a way that the poetry remained more important. And from that point onwards, Sahir began to assert himself, the Pyasa 57, saying that the poetry is more important in Hindi films than music. Immediately after that, he met O.P. Nayyar, who Sahir met O.P. Nayyar. They were working on Sone Ki Chidiya. And he said something derogatory about Dada Barman, who? Sahir. When he said something derogatory about Sahir, I mean, Nayyar told him, O.P. was a very bold person that O.P. told him, if you can speak of a senior composer like this, tomorrow you will be speaking like this about me to someone else. I don't want to work with you. Straight away he dropped him, O.P. Nayyar. He didn't want to work with him.
His songs often reflected his views in society.
जब भी जीता है नई दुनिया बता लेते हैं लोग एक चेहरे पे कई चेहरे लगा ले
In Yash Chopra's Dark, for example, he came down heavily on feudalistic and chauvinistic attitudes of society with this song.
Sahir, for instance, when B.R. Chopra took B.R. Chopra incidentally was the first to build a mansion in, build a bungalow in Bombay. When he took me around, he showed at the end of the bungalow there was a cottage. He said, this is meant for Sahir. I said, what is the logic? He says, he's very special to us. You see, and whenever he feels that he has to have a place where he could come and sit down and write what he wants, not necessarily film poetry, he is welcome here, and this is his adda, the exact word he used. This is his adda. He could come to this any time. And this Chopra's thought very specially of. And when Yash Chopra broke with B.R. Chopra and went away to do Daag, you know, Sharmila Tagore, Rajesh Khanna, Rakhi, Rakhi scoring in that film, very strong. When he went to do that film, I mean, we were very keen to see what Sahir would do. Because Sahir was associated with B.R. Chopra camp. But he didn't take sides. He was as much with B.R. Chopra as with Yash Chopra. And he wrote as well in this camp as he did for Ravi in B.R. Chopra's camp.
He expressed his disillusionment with Nehru's socialism with songs such as this.
रहने को घर नहीं है सारा जहां हमारा
रहने को घर नहीं है सारा जहां हमारा.
In 1977, Sahir won his second Filmfare Award. This would also be his last.
मैं जिंदगी का साथ निभाता चला गया.
He left an indelible mark on Hindi film music, something which will be cherished by generations to come.
मैं पल दो पल का शायर हूँ, पल दो पल मेरी कहानी है, पल दो पल मेरी हस्ती है.
अब क्या मिसाल दूँ मैं तुम्हारे शबाब की, हम और तुम और ये समा क्या नशा नशा सा है.
तुम बिन जाऊँ कहाँ के दुनिया में आके, कुछ न फिर चाह सनम तुमको चाह के.
Part of the formidable quartet that ruled Hindi cinema in the 1950s and early 60s, Majroo Sultanpuri outlasted them all by working right up to his death. His career spanning over 5 decades, over 350 films, many of them extremely successful at the box office.
In the case of Majroo, he was an expert in writing to tune. You know, very, very good and very, very quick in writing to tune. In effect, he became the total freelance. And in my opinion, as a result, his reputation suffered because he worked with any music director. He also worked with the biggest music directors. I mean, he worked with Roshan very effectively. You see, he worked with Chitragupta very well. Even then, I mean, so many of them, but he worked with everyone, but with no one in particular. Whereas Sahir, you could say, straight away it would be Roshan. You see, in the case of Sahir, I mean, he was very careful.
Born in Sultanpur, he was an established Hakim when he happened to recite his ghazals at a mushaira held in Sultanpur. He became a famous poet. It was in 1945 that a friend introduced him to A.R. Kardar.
Jab usne ge soobit raaye badal aaya jhoom ke. महका बुलबुल चहका गुंचा महका बुलबुल चहका नाचे भंवरा घूम के जब उसने गेसू बिखराए बादल आया झूम के.
दिस फिल्म would also feature a song which would become iconic in every respect.
Jab dil hi toot gaya, jab dil hi toot gaya, hum jee ke kya karenge, hum jee ke kya karenge, jab dil hi toot gaya, jab dil hi toot gaya.
Well, Majju Saab said one thing to me which I have kept it in mind. He said, beta, what I write is not important, but what sound I make in your song is important. So he was very, very careful about how the song is going to sound after he puts on the word. Phonetics. He was the best I've ever worked with, I must say.
Majru's songs touch the core of human experience. Although a product of classical Urdu poetry, his film songs adhere to simple Hindustani, which struck a chord in both the commoner and the connoisseur alike.
अरे जाने कहाँ मेरा बिगड़ गया जी, अभी अभी यहीं था किधर गया जी.
However, just as things were looking up, Majru Saab's inclination towards the left and his anti-establishment poetry got him arrested with others like Balraj Sahni in 1949.
If you spoke to Majru, he considered himself every inch as good a poet as Sahir. But he says that Sahir always gets the credit, I don't. This is what Majru told me and I was astonished because Majru was a very good poet. But then I analyzed, then I came to one conclusion. That in the case of Majru, what used to happen was, he was a card-holding member of the Communist Party of India. He was a great critic of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He could land in jail any time. And in films, people don't want this kind of a hassle ever. They want a free field. And this was not always assured in Majru's early days.
Finally, he broke through again with Guru Dutt's Aar Paar.
Babu ji dheere chalna, kari zara sambhalna. Bade dhoke hai is raah mein. Babu ji dheere chalna, kari zara sambhalna.
If you have to tell him one thing, he would take it into his mind very carefully, and he was very, very precise in his meter in writing. That was Majru Sultan Puri Sahib's most memorable thing that I remember, and the kind of sound that he would make in a song was just magical.
Although Majru Sultan Puri worked with all the top music directors of the day, Anil Biswas, Naushad, Madan Mohan, O.P. Nair, Roshan and Lakshmikant Pyarelal, his association with S.T. Barman stands out.
गीत में तेरे लिए जलते हैं जिसके लिए.
In one word, if I was to describe Majru Sultan Puri, it would be awesome. One, because I grew up hearing the songs of Majru Uncle, but especially the numbers of Teesri Manzil. I couldn't understand how, when, and what provoked him to write those beautiful songs.
His work with the latter in the frothy Nasir Hussain musicals have all been major hits.
Tumne mujhe dekha ho kar meherban ruk gayi ye zameen जाने जा तुमने मुझे देखा होकर मेहरबान।
हरे 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 अच्छो मिली है तू बाहों को बाहों मेरा ले दे साजना झूठे के झूठे है होठों को होठों से कहने दे साजना ना ना अच्छो मिली है तू बाहों को बाहों मेरे ले दे साजना सच्चे के झूठे हैं होठों को होठों से कहने दे साजना ना ना जो मिले हैं तो हरे 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 साजना।
यादों की बारात निकली है आज दिल के द्वारे सपनों की शहनाई बीते दिनों को पुकारे दिल के द्वारे छेड़ो तराने मिलन के प्यारे प्यारे संग हमारे।
He could be versatile. If only Majru had restricted himself a little. If only he had recognized his own true worth as a poet. But then he always had this complex about Shahir Ludhianvi and was in a hurry to see that he caught up with him. You don't catch up that way. Not in films. You catch up with no one in films, in fact. Because things come to you. You don't go and try for it, you won't get it.
Even though his career spanned almost 4,000 songs, he won his only Filmfare Award for Dosti.
Jaunga main tujhe saanj savere Phir bhi kabhi ab naam ko tere Aawaz main na dunga Aawaz main na dunga चाहूंगा मैं तुझे आज सवेरे।
The fact that not many awards were bestowed upon him rankled the maestro a lot. He felt cheated. He publicly expressed his anger when he lost the Filmfare Award for this song.
पहला नशा, पहला खुमार, नया प्यार है, नया इंतजार। कर लूं मैं क्या अपना हाल ऐ दिले बेकरार मेरे दिले बेकरार तू ही बता।
I had a chance to work with him in Akele Hum Akele Tum, and this very place, you know, I had a chance. He came home and we had these numerous sittings, and he was a child. He was more childlike than even Annu Malik. I'm a child myself, I'm not grown up. But he was such a child. He was very short tempered. One word that we required, Majru Uncle, ye change karte, ha ha, pura gaana change kar do. You know, ye mukhra bhi change kar do. You know, that kind of thing. And after 2 minutes of shouting, he used to calm down. And there were these hugs, and there was this duas, you know, that used to come from him. And I remember every song what he wrote for Akele Hum Akele Tum was for me a milestone in my career, thanks to Mansoor Khan, who directed the film. And Nasir Uncle and Mansoor have always had such a great equation with Majru Uncle.
Raja ko Rani se pyaar ho gaya, pehli nazar mein pehla pyaar ho gaya, dil jigar dono khayal huye, tere nazar dil ke paar ho gaya.
Majru Sultanpuri's contribution to Hindi films will remain as one of the most exceptional ones. As a lyricist who transcended generations and remains truly special till this day.
Ek din bik jayega maati ke mol, jag mein reh jayenge pyare tere ko, tujhe ke honton ko dekhkar apne hi कोई निशानी छोड़ फिर दुनिया से।